is actually a function? A function is a special type of relation which should meet two criteria. A function is a special type of relation which should meet how many criteria? Two criteria. And what are they? The criteria number one is, every element, these are called elements, every element in the pre-image set should have an image. That's criteria number one. Write it down. Every element in pre-image set, must have an image. Image means image of 1 is 4. So every element should have an image. Every element in the pre-image set should have an image. Is that happening over here? Yes. There is no element in set A which is left unmapped. Had there been a case like that, then that relation would not be called as a function. Let's say there was another element 5. Hypothetically, let's say, assume there was a 5. Correct? Or even 5 as in, let's say 6. I think it looks like 6 only. Okay. 6. 6 should have been mapped to 9. But is 9 present in set B? No, so 6 cannot be mapped. So 6 is unmapped. And when 6 is unmapped, that means this criteria is getting violated. That means every pre-image does not have an image anymore. And then in that case, I would not call this relation as a function. So this is criteria number one. Criteria number two, as what Shay has told, is the image of the pre-image must be unique. That means I should not get two outputs for the same input. I should not get two answers for the same value of the pre-image element. For example, if I put 1, in this case it will only give me 4. It will not give me 5, or it will not give me 10, it will not give me 100. Correct? Now you must be wondering, when does that happen actually? When can I have two different outputs for the same input? For example, if I give you a relation like this, y square is equal to x. Correct? Let's say my pre-image now is 4. Correct? What is the image associated with it? Or what is the y value associated with it? Plus and minus 2. Correct? So in such cases, what will happen? You would see that I'm just drawing a miniature arrow diagram. For a pre-image 4, it will map to 2 also. It will map to minus 2 also. This should not happen in a function. So this will not be called a function. Are you getting it? Now people ask me, why are these two restrictions put on a relation to be called as a function? Plain and simple. Just try to relate it to functions in real life. What are functions? Is this mobile playing a function for me? Yes. I make calls from it. I see my messages and my mails from it, right? Is the marker playing a role for me? Let's say simple toast machine, toaster. Does it play a functionality for you? Yes. Now let's say you have a toaster in your house, correct? And you try to put a piece of bread in it, and it doesn't give you any output from it. What will you do? Take it and throw it out of the house, right? You say, what is this machine? It's not playing its functionality. Yes or no? So when you put something, it should give you an output as per the manual of the function, isn't it? So if an input doesn't give you an output, then that particular mathematical machine is not functioning and hence not a function. Correct. Now again, the same machine, let's say, one day you put a bread and it gives you a toast. The same bread you put the next day and it gives you a pizza. I know you will be happy to see that. But you say, your dabba machine. One day it is giving me toast, other day it is giving me pizza. Again, what you will do? Throw it out of your house, isn't it? So you cannot expect different outcomes from the same input. Bread means toast should come out. It should not give you surprises Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday and Friday. Okay? Simple logic governs the criteria that I have given to you. That's it. Understood? So what are the two criteria here? The word every and the word unique. Remember this. Every and unique, if you remember. Every pre-image must have a unique image is the one line explanation for what makes a relation a function. Understood? Now few technical terms. Again, coming from layman to not technical words, because you will be getting to see them in your textbooks. There is something called domain. Have you heard of this word? Not that domain of your websites. Domain. What's the domain, Aditya? No, shares.
Domain is x-axis.
Ah, good. Again, let me just. Actually, I prefer a whiteboard, but today I have to show you some graphs. That's why this census is being used. Else, many of the classes will happen on the whiteboard only. What's the domain? There are some words that you'll come across. One is domain. Okay. And other is range. Okay. Domain are basically those elements of set A which are getting mapped. Okay. Right now I'm not talking in terms of functions. I'm talking in terms of relations. So let's say I had a 6 over here. Then what are the elements in set A which are getting mapped? 1, 2, 3 and 4. That's it. Right? These elements would be called the domain. So how is domain different from the pre-image set? Pre-image set will contain all the set, all the elements. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 6. Only the ones which are getting mapped would be called domain. Understood? Understood? No, I'll explain it again. You are Neha, right? Yes. Neha. Sure you're not joking, right? I can't believe myself. Okay, I remember somebody's name in one book. So domain is basically the elements which are getting mapped. Getting mapped means they are participating in that relation. Right? So those will only constitute the domain. However, all of them would constitute a pre-image set. Understood the difference? Pre-image set versus domain. Pre-image set will contain everything in set A. Whether it's getting mapped or not getting mapped. But domain will contain only those ones which are getting mapped. Understood that? What is range? Range are those elements of set B which are getting mapped. Correct? So Ashish, what do you think is the domain here? Oh, sorry, range here. Is it too small? You want to come here? Ronak, what is the range here? Should I repeat the definition once again? Range are those elements of set B which are getting mapped or which are participating in that relation. So what are the ones which are participating in the relation? 4, 5, 6 and 7. So 4, 5, my 5 is so bad. 5, 6, 7. This is your range. Correct? Now the difference you know between range and the image set. Will not make a difference, will not make a mistake in that. Okay? So who will stand up and explain me? This is domain, this is pre-image set. This is range, this is image set. Who will stand up and explain it? Skand, will you like to try? Sit and speak, no worries. You want my mic? You will be loud and clear? Yeah.
A pre-image set is a set. First set which is to be compared with the
other. Okay, so here the set which contains your X is your pre-image. Okay.
And the set,
what's the domain?
Domain is the getting mapped.
Absolutely. The elements inside A which are participating in the relation are getting mapped. Correct? Aditya, will you explain the difference between range and image set?
Okay, the image is all the elements with respect to Y.
Okay, so basically a set which contains
all the values.
Which contains the set or which contains the elements from where Y is to be picked up. That is called the image set. But the Ys which are actually getting picked up or getting mapped, those will be called the
image.
Understood the difference now?
Okay.
Now this is a definition which is more or less true even for a function. The only difference being, this was in terms of relation I was talking about, the only difference being, in case of a function, there is nothing called pre-image set. Everything is a domain. Why is that so? Because of criteria number one. Because every element of the pre-image has to participate. There is no option given to them. You have to come and participate. So when they have to participate, doesn't the pre-image set itself becomes your domain? Understood. So six should not be there at all. First of all, I am removing this. So 1, 2, 3, 4 is also the pre-image set and will also be the domain because of the criteria number 1 which I have written. Every element of the pre-image set must participate in the mapping. There is no option for them to be left out. If they do, then you are not eligible to be called a function. Understood this? Clear? Shushant, right? Achievement. Okay. And in case of relation, in case of function, this pre-image, this image set is given a different name. It's called codomain. Just to rhyme with domain, it is given a different name, codomain. What is the codomain? Codomain is basically your image set. So we say image set in case of relations, but in case of functions, the same thing is called a codomain. Why it is called codomain? Just to rhyme with the word domain. That's it. Correct? So, no. That's what I'm going to come now. Codomain are all the elements of the set B. But range is only those elements of codomain which participate in the mapping. So here codomain would be 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. While range will be 4, 5, 6 and 7 only. Understand? What's your good name? Aditi. Oh my god, so many people have the same name in this class. 3 Adityas, 2 Aditis, 3 Ananyas.
Yes.
The name codomain is just coined for functions. In relations, we don't use the word codomain. We use the word the image set. Is it the nomenclature has changed? Functionality-wise, nothing has changed. Understood? Now, summing up this entire thing. Now, if you know the difference between pre-image set and domain, do you know the difference between image set and codomain? Actually, there is no difference, just in the name. But do you know the difference between codomain and range now?
Yeah.
Right. So, 5 terms you have heard today. Pre-image, domain, image, codomain, range. Okay? I am again summarizing it. The word domain and codomain are used in case of functions. Correct? In case of relations, we use the word domain, pre-image, image, range. Okay? Anyway, this is something which I will again talk about in the chapter Relations and Functions.